Good morning. Welcome to DDOwiki Talk with your host, Technical 13, aka ShoeMaker. How is everybody this morning? Get the chat up here so we can see what's going on. I have no cam this week. Ooh, that doesn't work. Just a second, let me fix the something real quick. Set a background for this so you can actually see what I say. Does that fix it? No, it does not. Text box behind it then. Like that, then down, move it down over here in the corner, down to be the size of what my cam was, and then put down in the list. There we go. Yeah, there we go. That much looks much better. All right, so how is everybody this week? There's no cam this week because I'm having to broadcast from a remote location. I'm not at home this week. My internet was shut off. Got injured at work and they cut my hours, so anyway, you want to help me get back home, there's a link in my scrolling banner at the top to Streamlabs to make a donation towards the Turn the Internet Back On goal. Let me turn my fan up, my CPU, so it doesn't hit 70 degrees. Ideally, I'd like it to stay below 60, but it doesn't usually happen when I'm streaming. But let's start adding the first couple people to the code giveaway. We're going to be giving away a starter pack this week. If we can get to 25 viewers, I think is what we set it at last week. So let's add MNEMMY and welcome back, Mayquist. I haven't seen you in chat for quite a while. Good morning, Amaref. Say hello in chat if you're there. Episode 56. School has been rough. Yes, I understand that. Alright, so if that's all we have for now, let's head into here. You can see that we have our happy 11th anniversary banner up. I'm not quite convinced I like the colors, but I haven't had a lot of time to really work on it. There's a page on the giveaway. We should check that out. We should make an edit to this so it's not a stub, but I'll have to do that from other page, from my other account. Let's see here. Showing up as a stub because it's linking to a disambiguation page. Because there was a 10th anniversary and 11th anniversary that are the same. As far as the quest goes. Although there are two iterations of it, so I decided that it was prudent to separate the page into a 10th and an 11th. Oh, let's see here. Mania defaults to fault, so I get rid of that. Show preview. Anniversary party challenge. Okay, so that'll be updated. Link directly to the 11th anniversary version. And when we update the page over here now, and we scroll down, we'll be able to see that it's now a blue link instead of a maroonish red one because it goes to anniversary party 11th. Take a look at that while we're at it. Eleven-year-old cake. Wondrous bound to account things. Bound to account being the theme here. The 11-year-old cake is a free giveaway celebrating DDO's 11th anniversary on February 23rd, 5 days ago. Unlike previous birthday cakes, this one is not distributed to each character, but rather is available as a redeemable coupon from the DDO store. Coupon code HAPPY11TH, twice per account. The cake can be used until April 2nd. After that, it will remain in inventory but not be tradable, which means that you won't be able to interact with it. Double-clicking the cake opens the trade interface, allowing you to polymorph the cake into one of the following items, all bound to account on acquire except as noted below. And each of the items you can mouse over and see what the item is in the list here. You can quickly scroll through. I recommend starting at the bottom of the list and moving your way up. Just quickly scroll through and see what you want each has to say. The 1000k experience is applied instantly to the character, and it is affected by any bonuses that are currently running for the character, including but not limited to VIP bonus, XP elixir, ship buffs, etc. I think I got like 132k per stone, because I picked two stones for one of my characters. I got almost 270k out of it, so went from level 4 to level 9, I think it is. 10 commendations of heroism. Lucid dreams, working your way right up through. See, also, this list is final. They're not going to be adding anything to the list. When they did that last year, people got upset that they used their cake and didn't get to get one of the new items, so they just decided that the list is the list this time. They're not going to add anything to it. Anniversary party, 11th. The 11th anniversary iteration. I actually haven't been into the quest at all. So I don't know what has changed. I'll admit I've been slacking on DDO a little bit lately. I've been doing a lot of Lord of the Rings Online, trying to get some stuff done. I'm a plugin developer. I also work on their wiki some. Whole bunch of stuff. And then I've also started the night before last playing another game called Stardew Valley, which is kind of fun. I'll be back to DDO. I'm not gone. Just needed a little break, a little breakup, so. Let's see here. What do we have in recent changes? Let's have a look and see what's happened in the last week. Epic reincarnation, borrower's back, Reaper difficulty changes, starting a warlock, category talk. I wasn't aware that there was something there. Item talk, ring of the stalker. L20 tier 3 changed. Talk Siegebreaker. Lawful Outsider. Some changes to Potion of Wonder. But he added a comment to it, and I replaced it with a link to the video because it's just so much easier to watch a video than it is to do text. Free to play DDO point walkthrough. Updated. Elminster had something trimmed out. New template for commendation of heroism. A lot of 11th, some 11th anniversary stuff. A lot of work on the pages themselves by Lord Silverhand or Lady Silverhand. Torque, string table error. Torque is no longer a skeleton, he's now a rust monster, so that was one of the changes that they did this year. Storm Rage, starting a fighter. Oh, a lot of starting A page changes by Hasty Pudding. That's awesome. Those pages definitely need some work. They're quite out of date. Assistance, Madstone Crater, user talk. Welcome, not minor. I hadn't seen the response yet to that. Let's see here. Item talk, Cloak of Flames. It's a massive update on fixing the classes and the skill pages so that they would display properly. BDO, what's that? Big donuts online. I'm all for some big donuts. Black Desert Online. Interesting. All right, so on the all of the skill pages, it now has the icon, the link, the what it is in bold, and the modifier. Cleaned it up so that it's no longer trying to link back to itself. Although I might change this to just intelligence, I don't know yet. The reason we did that is that on the class pages, the list here wasn't populating properly. So the whole class skill section is now a template. If we go down here, it's now a template. Let me see if I can find it. Wait, what? Class skill. It's not a template? Did I put that in the wrong place? Skill modifier, class skill. There are a few templates here. Here it is, template class skill. Oh, that's right. I updated the top of the table up here to make it all the three level abbreviations and shorten it a little bit. This page should be using the template that it's not. So there's a template here, skill modifier. Where was the other one? There it is, skill ability and class skill phantom. So we got our phantom template here. Skill ability, class skills, and skill modifier. New templates, skill modifier just says take whatever the page name is. Actually, I should update that. It should be class or page name. This will allow us to use this other places. Okay. Good morning, Nervigen. Add you to the giveaway list here. NYRVGN. Spelling on that always gets me. Almost down to where I can actually see the messages. That's moderator. We're up to 4 of 25. It's a slow start. I'll probably run a little bit over today. So tell your friends. Get the tweet out. Actually, I should put a tweet out. To Twitter. Where is it? I'm pretty sure it's technical 13. Let me head to Twitter real quick and make sure that I get this right. All right, let's get that tweet out there. Retweet it. Copy a link to the tweet. There we go. That matter. Shrink this for a second. Let's see here. Doing a quick little posting. Best part about the starter pack to me has always been that if you're a free-to-play player, it makes you premium free-to-play and gives you some more, a whole bunch more access. Alrighty. Feel free to pop into the Discord channels if you'd like to chat on stream. Back over here, bring this back up. Alrighty. So here's our class skill phantom. See that it's just the image, the linked title, trimming out the word skill if it happens to be in there, it disembig. And then it pulls the skill ability from the skill ability template, which is right here, which is just a switch. If one or skill or page name is jump, jump skill, swim, then it's STR. I actually don't like that. I think I want to spell the words out. Strength. Dexterity. Constitution, intelligence, wisdom, charisma. I also want to add no include. Examples in there. I'm just going to do them all. So I've got jump, UMD, jump. I don't know. Pick another one. Heal. Alrighty, let's see here. What do we got? We got recognizes most all accepted shown below. Okay, so we got jump. Jump skill. Swim. Val. I can just go like this. I can't. Okay. Balance. Silently open lock. Good morning, McVegan Pants. Let's add you to the giveaway list here. Welcome. We're up to 20% of the way. Good morning, Dank. Yes, I can do both of those MacQuests. I didn't have them in there, but I certainly can. Dank dabs a lot. Okay. Anybody else in chat this morning? What is in a starter pack? That is a great question. And to answer that question, let's go to the wiki page on it. Good morning, Gipoldra. Let's add you to the giveaway here, and then we'll go over what's in a starter pack. So a starter pack includes the Catacombs Adventure Pack, Fiendish Scorpion Pet, a Permanent Cleric Hireling, 5 Excellent Elixir Experience Elixirs, which gives you 30% bonus for 3 hours, 250 DDO points. Additionally, if you're a fully free-to-play character and you've never purchased anything from the DDO store or VIP or Turbine Points or anything like that, it will also make you a premium free-to-play character. Premium free to play. See also account comparisons. This is a good place to go for this. It gives you 2 additional character slots. It gives you an additional monster manual. It gives you volume 1 of the monster manual by being premium.
Well met.
Thanks for the host, Dank. Let's see here. The login queue means nothing. It gives you unlimited chat. It gives you 50 items at a time in the auction house. It gives you the normal game limit for platinum storage, so you're no longer restricted to 1250 platinum times 2 to your level minus 1. You'll cap out at 4 million platinum right from the get-go. It gives you full access to customer service for the starter pack. I believe it's for 30 days, I'm not sure. Full access to the official forums. And then your idle logout, I'm not sure what's up with that. That doesn't seem accurate, but... And it also gives you a 40-item buyback history as opposed to 10, even though it's supposed to be only 10. Yes, you could. So, not only does it give it the stuff that it gives you, it also gives you some other stuff by becoming... by making you premium if you weren't already. Okay, so it was suggested to add one for moves silently. And moves silently was just moves silent. And then for open lock, somebody suggested making it plural. I should probably do the same thing for disabled device on the plural. Probably make hiding. Nobody would do that. Okay, so concentration. So let's add these here. Move silence is an easy copy paste. Done. Disable device is a simple copy paste. Copy, paste, paste S. Open lock. Copy, paste, paste. S, we're up to concentration. All right, so the next one is repair, repair skill. Search. Can never remember what the other thing spellcraft is called, but there is some, it's called something else. I don't remember what it is, but I should add that, figure it out, and add that too. Alright, so we get to spellcraft. What's next on the list? Heal. Heal. Skill. Listen. Spot. Buff, Diplo, Diplomacy, Haggle, Tim, Timmy, T in there. Intimidate. Form. UMD. Magic device. I can see people misspelling that. I'm gonna add that as well. If they misspell it, that's their problem. Alright, so let's do this. Copy, paste, close. Copy. Paste, paste, paste. Paste. Copy, paste. Copy, paste. Copy, paste. Copy, paste. Spell power, that's the one I think I was thinking of. All right. Oh, so disable devices, it doesn't react. Oh, that's because I haven't updated it for that yet. I haven't added you to the list yet. Gives us 8 of our 25 attendees. Yeah, 5 columns is going to be too wide, isn't it? Make it 3, see what that looks like. That's good. The only thing left that I should do... is wrap each one of these... code tags. What will that look like? Doesn't really define it very much. Undo that. Not gonna let me undo that. Alright, I'll manually undo that then. do this. There we go. Alrighty, it's getting chilly in here. Turn the heat up. I got it set for 62. Let's turn it up to 66, nobody will notice. If it even works. Nope, I need to update, fix that so that it's a list. There we go. Strength, dexterity, constitution, intelligence, wisdom, charisma, and that is that. Alrighty. Our next page, let's see here. This is our class skills template. So all of the class skills sections were replaced with this, which is an include only class skills. Skill points at first level is skill modifier plus intelligence modifier times 4. Skill points at each additional level is skill modifier plus intelligence modifier. And then it's a DPL, skills and page name. Takes two categories, skills and the page name skills. Class skill Phantom, which we already looked at. Makes a table with no border, that's 3 columns. Simple DPL query. Skill modifier is simply whatever the class is. Tells you how many points they get. Rogues get 8, bards and rangers get 6, artificers, barbarians, druids, and monks get 4, and everybody else gets 2. And here's our spellcraft page for an example. Icon, spellcraft, intelligence. Nice. And then our wizard. Concentration, repair, spellcraft, links to the skill page, and whatever the type is for it. It looks very nice. Wizards get 2 plus intelligence modifier. Alright. Let's fix that. I can't spell. Do I have a list, a help list pages? I do not. So let's see where that is. Alrighty. How long have I been doing this? November of 2009, so 7 years, I believe. I started November 11th, 2009. I should add a little thing there that tells how long ago that was. I'll get back to that. Let's add the new names to the list here. We've got ETAVV, And BANOLDU. Save. 10 of 25. We're at 40% of the number of people that we need to say hi. If you're lurking in chat, say hi. Looks like we've got 13 viewers right now, according to XSplit. Tell your friends and guildies to pop on in. Retweet that tweet. Alright, so let's see here. Quest list. None. I want video, help, forum. Help editing. Let's make it a redirect to that. There we go. Alrighty. And throw that in now. Chops that. We don't need the mug. Until I get my internet back on. There we go. I should update that template. Template not minor. I'm pretty sure we have a button template now. Let's see here. Let's try this. We have a button template? We don't have a button template? We need to make one. I could have sworn I had a template. Oh, maybe it's keypress I'm thinking of. probably about 45 minutes to an hour left of the stream today. We need to make a button template. Where's the free punch and pie? It's coffee time. Good morning, Mike Man. M1KEMAN. You make number 11. How are you today? Span class fake button. ID equals Well, we can add them to the list. Let's see here. P-E-P... O-H-U... Yeah, that makes number 12. That means we should remove Mike Man and move him down. There we go. Let's do that. I'd say that's the 50% mark, pretty close to it. All right, so we got a span class fake button, whatever's passed into it, all capital letters button. Save that page. In order for me to complete this project, I am going to need edit mwcommon.js. And in order to do that, I'm going to need to open up a new browser window with my account on it. I'm going to blow this up to 150% here. But before we do that, I want to edit this. Hey, Lawful Eye, welcome to the stream. I want to, if the person doesn't have JavaScript, I want to try to make it look as much like a button as possible. So I'm going to add some CSS to it to try to make it emulate a button as best as I can. Okay, style equals. So, it's got black border, border 1px, solid black. Okay, there's our black border, although it's not exactly black. So, I'm going to use this little application that I have called Color Picker that will allow me to pull the color of the border. Just like that. So I can delete that and put the color of the actual border in there. Now, it looks like there might be a gradient there. Let's inspect the colors. So, there is a gradient. It goes from F7s at the top all the way down to all D's. Okay, F7 to D. CSS gradient. Let's see here. How to use gradients. I've actually never bothered with gradients before. So, what I want is a linear gradient. So, what I need is to copy this. Linear gradient should be background color. Never use background. And we have, let's see here, the top color for the button was F7s, and the bottom colors was all D's. See here, what's that look like? That doesn't make a difference. I get rid of the background color. Maybe it is background because it's not a color, it's a gradient. There it is. Okay. So, I've got that to work now. The next part is I need to add some padding. That's actually a save page button. I haven't added lawful lie yet, so let's do that before I forget. All right, so what's our padding on this? I gotta check some chats real quick. Looks like somebody's in Discord. Is DDO going to make more high-level hirelings soon? I added you to the drawing. You are now entered to win a starter pack. All right, so we checked Discord real quick. It's a drawing for a starter pack. There's a link to it if you'd like to go check that out. Alright, so what do we have for padding? I can also use this. It allows me to view pixel by pixel, so I can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, so about 8 or 9 pixels there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if I do a padding of 7px, 9px, is that right? That's too big. Okay. Maybe I got them backwards. Maybe it's 9px, 7px. Nope, that was the other way. Definitely the other way. But it's way too big. So let me just try a flat 4px. While I'm working on this, I'm actually going to actually make it a save page button. Looks like it might be a 3.6. Color is going to be is it black on that? Let's take a look. Is it actually black for the text for the save for the buttons? Oh. I'm gonna say yes, even though you can see that there's a whole bunch of colors in there. I'm gonna go with black. And it looks like can't shrink that any. Looks like the corners might actually be rounded slightly. They are. Very, very lightly rounded. Okay, so, and our corners are very, very square. Okay, so, CSS rounded corners, border radius property. I can set a border radius, and it's literally 1px. See how that looks. Other than the colors look a little bit darker, it's almost identical. So why do the colors look darker? F7 to all D's. F7 to all D's. So I guess it's not darker. Let's change this back to button. DDO Grubby. Good morning, Entomix. Barrel Knee. Or Haws Are Gone. Spindance. Say good morning in chat. So you can be entered into the drawing. Shrink that for a second so I can bring this up. Let's see here. Let me bring up the links for the chat. There we go. You can pop into voice chat and say hello. I'll add the on click later. Just add the ID for now. All right. So I'm going to work on that for now. Leave that as is for now, I should say. We got Haws Are Gone. We've got Barrel New York. Bar I Love New York. And now we're 60% of the way there. We need 10 more people. Got about half an hour, 45 minutes left for chat here. And let me bring this up real quick so I can run one of these. I've got shortcuts in there. Feel free to give me a follow as well. Post those in there. All right, my quest, I'll keep that in mind. All right, here is our button. All righty. now have a save page button. I can change this to clicking, save page, and then get rid of the button. Awesome. Doesn't actually do anything yet, but making progress. Welcome to the DDOwiki Discord channel, veteran. I don't know why it says it's flagged for deletion. That's weird. Oh, subst only templates. I don't know. There's something weird in that system I gotta figure out someday. But not today! Alright, that's the not minor template. So let's head back over to button real quick. And what I want to do is add an on-click event. Actually, if it says click, then I expect the parameter being passed into click to be what it's supposed to do when they click the button. Happy DDO Day. Welcome to the stream. INGDTON. Welcome also, Dukent. Say hi in chat to be entered in the drawing. Okay, so I don't have to do anything else here. Okay, so what I can do, I can go to the console here. I need to fix that sometime. There you are. Welcome. Okay. If I go like this. So what I want to do is... If it's a span fake button, so that's there. ID isn't correct. Oh, because there isn't an ID. Actually, define it as empty, otherwise define it as what it is. Actually, just define it as what it is. And if it's undefined, it's undefined. I don't have any place where it will put in what the contents are supposed to be. what it's supposed to do. Okay. Button undefined, undefined. No click button. Why did it pass? Oh, that's fine. Button click. It didn't pull what was in on click. Why didn't it pull what was in on click? Ah. Test. Actually, that should always be text. So I'm going to change that to button text. Make sure that it's text. Button's not undefined. Pull whatever's an on click. Still undefined. Spec the element. Class fake button, ID no click button. Why is that showing up like that? Oh, it's stripping out the onclick. That's why. Welcome, mediocre mouse. Probably get another 15 minutes, half an hour to get your friends in here. Looks like we're going to fall short of our 25 chatter goal. On click gets stripped out. I need to replace that with something. Action? Hope that gets stripped out too. Oh, name. Can I put a name or a title in there? ID. I can't put a name. How about a title? Tidy sure makes this tough. Ooh, I can put a title in there. Sweet, I found one. Okay, so we're gonna make this title. There we go. That's what I want. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Okay. So what I need to do is take this information and I need to create a button. Bar real button equals. Inspect the element for the button itself. Input. I need to get the ID. So it's going to be input. It's not what I want. If button ID not, I already got that, so I can delete that. Real button plus equals. We're going to add in ID equals. button ID, put the ID back in. Is it too late? No, it's not too late. But let's add a couple new people. Let's see here. SHL shall del. You shall delete this after you see if you win or not. Oh, CHEFTIN. You shall delete your character and reroll. FEUERHAAR 93. 21. Four more to go. Got until I finish writing this piece of script, and then we'll see if we have enough people. All right, so we got our button ID. Then the next thing is the on click event, which is going to be button click. ID. Space. Click. Good morning, good morning, good morning. CREX is Pendragons. Zoomazir. Darius 1680. Testing out Discord for the first time. Are you in the... are you in the text chat for DDOwiki? Or are you in the voice chat for DDO Stream? Those are the links for text and voice. If you wish to donate to help me turn my internet back on at home, the link is in the Monastery of the Scorpion. Link's not working in Wiki, by the way. We'll go take a look at that as soon as we get done with the script, after the drawing. Ah, before the drawing. What the heck? Okay, so there's that. Real button plus equals. We close the button. Whatever the button text is, we'll put that in there. Now, is there anything else that we should add to the button? We need to add type equals button to it. All right. So input, ID, the null click button, on click, test, type, button, button. Let's see what happens.
Hello?
Hello, welcome. How are you today?
Doing good.
Glad to see you in here, Starla.
Yeah, I kind of missed all you guys.
So now, actually, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do so what I got to do is I'm going to move this up here. No, I don't. I need an ID, so it'll always have to have an ID. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll move this out here. Always need an ID. Okay. You guys actually can't see that, can you? That help any? Not really. I do this. There you go. Now you can see it. This is what I'm working on for code. There we go. I'm going to then replace the button once I create it. Real button. Input. Get the ID. Put the ID in there. Button ID should never be undefined. I'm gonna check and see if title is defined. Title's not undefined, then add the title. Hello?
Oh, my mic working?
Absolutely. Welcome, veteran. All right, let's do a test here. Copy this. So what happened? Oh, I know what happened. Okay. Let's try this again. Nope, still happened. Can't forget to add Starla to the drawing, and that gives us our 25 attendees needed, so we will be doing a drawing. Alright, let's see here, fake button, ID, use the first lowercase, whatever it is, button, if click exists, title is click, style. I should put my class in there, but that's not why it's breaking. ID, click, class. Actually, ID. Then class. Title's not undefined. Then get the title. On click title. Actually. Type should be for ID. Type button, ID, class, on click, close that, add the button text, add the closing tag. What's it adding? Put type button ID null button class fake button on click test button slash input. Oh, that's why. Get rid of that. Space slash. Value. Now, let's see what happens. Not much change. But now, it's actually a clickable button that doesn't do anything. Excellent. So, get rid of this here. Not clickable. Copy this from here. Let's bring up common.js. Let's edit this. What is today? Today is the 28th February 2017.
It's also Fat Tuesday if you tend to like New Orleans things.
Oh, yeah? I thought every Tuesday was Fat Tuesday.
In New Orleans, probably.
Alrighty. Now when I reload this page, not clickable, even though it looks like an actual button. Nope, it's still using the span. Probably gonna have to purge the common.js page. Alright, let me go to the console, see why it's not working. Or I'll gadget delete things. So it just hasn't loaded yet. Alright, we'll get back to that. Chat. Welcome. Let's add you to the list. Supply carrier. Nuts. I guess the quest template overhaul will be my next project. Area of the Scorpion. Link seemed to be working for me. What do you mean, Darius, that the links aren't working? You mean the puzzle solver link? That's something outside of the purview of what DDOwiki controls. You'd have to get in touch with whoever runs Axiom Files and have them fix it. Hello, amigo. I have a template for that. Deadline, maybe? Nope. Called age. A year, month. Year, month, and day. And it wants a numeric value for month. A complete overhaul. Whatever. Starting with my first wiki edit. Year, month, day. 7 years, 3 months, and 14 days. Hey, gummy bears. Alrighty, let's pull up the recent changes. Looks like Interison is back at work again. What are their contribs looking like? 43 edits. Not quite up there yet for VIP. All right, let's do our drawing and call it a stream. GUMMIBEARS24. Save our list. And drum roll, please. And the winner is... Congratulations. You were the 20th person to show up in chat today. So I'm going to call this a stream. Everybody have a... great day, and I will be on, probably Thursday night on the Lotro stream channel for ShoeMaker Streams Lotro. Hopefully my internet will be turned back on by then, and I won't have to do it from McDonald's or whatever. Using free Wi-Fi to stream is horrible. All right, so let me mute that in my ear real quick. If you wish to donate to help me get my internet turned back on, you can always visit my user page on DDOwiki, or at the scrolling banner at the top of the stream, you can see a Streamlabs link, or you can check out my personal Twitch page, which is... Let me link that real quick. All of those places have a place where you can click on the donation link. It's also in my forum signatures. Other than that, I will be on next week, Tuesday morning, for DDOwiki Talk. I'm not sure what I'll be giving away yet, if anything. I'll be on Thursday nights. I'm also starting to stream on my personal channel a little bit more, so give me a follow. And I'm going to work on putting together a regular schedule this week for streaming. I want to get in some DDO, some Lotro, some maybe some Drakensang online. I haven't played that in a while. And some Stardew Valley. So give me a follow, and I will catch you all later. Have a great week, everybody. Alrighty, that was fun. So, how are you guys today? There you go. Yeah, I've been streaming on Lotro Stream as well. Yeah, I understand that. I've got two 19-year-olds, a 14-year-old, a 5-year-old, and a 1-year-old, so. I know all about it. Absolutely.